Okay, today I will tell you about this very fascinating number.
4205147.
That's the fraction. Now, these are a special class of sequences called Somos sequences, and they go as follows. This is really a very fascinating story.
In general, it's called Somos K sequences,
where K can be a number.
So let's say you start from Somos 1.
It's just a string of 1s.
You can predict that the algorithm is simply an plus 1 is an, then equals 1. Yep.
It's very, very simple. Nothing magical is happening here. It's very not interesting. Now, Somos 2. I'm going to give you the algorithm, and we'll look at the sequences. And there is a pattern in this algorithms that will get clear in a minute. So once I start writing enough of these, you'll go, ah, that's the algorithm.
And you're starting from this, and you're saying A0 is 1, and since it's Somos 2, which means that A1 is also 1. If you want to compute A2, your sequence right now looks like this. You have 1 and 1. A2 will be A1 times A1 divided by A0, which will just be 1. Now look at what happens for A3. You get A2 times A2 divided by A1, which again is 1. So you can believe me that you'll only get string of 1s. Now
the sequence is not very interesting, but the algorithm is getting juicier.
Now let's go to Somos 3. The algorithm is an is an minus 1, an minus 2 divided by an minus 3. Our seed is going to be a0 is 1, a1 is 1, a2 is 1, right? So your sequence is starting from 3 1s. Now a3 is a2, a1, a0. This is 1.
I'm getting pretty sick of 1s.
Well, you need to wait slightly longer.
Okay.
So you have A4. Now, since you're already sick of 1s, you'll see another 1.
All right.
Because you have A3, A2, A1. So sorry, you have 1 again and 1 again.
It'll continue to be a string of 1s. Now you see, these are pretty boring at the moment. So the statement is that the first 3 terms of this different Somos K sequences, which means that Somos 1, 2, and 3 are all just strings of 1s. Nothing interesting happening, but it just gives you a feel of where the algorithm is going. Now we go to Somos 4. Will we see something interesting there, is the question.
I hope the answer is yes.
So the algorithm is an is, now I'll write it as a fraction.
Okay.
Numerator is going to be an minus 1. An minus 3 plus an minus 2 squared upon an minus 4 with a0 is 1. So it now has a string of 4 ones in the beginning.
And what numbers does that spit out?
Okay, so a4 is going to be a3, a1 plus a2 squared, a0. 1 plus 1 divided by 1, which is 2.
Oh, we got a new number.
Exactly. Now, what's happening with A5? If you do A5, it's going to be A4, A2 plus A3 squared upon A1, 3. So things are starting to move.
Still integers, though. We're still getting...
Still integers.
Mm.
Now, look at this. There is no reason that this should give you integers, right? So let's do another one.
See if we get fraction.
Yep.
That's the idea. You have A5, A3, A4. Now, you could say that I'm cheating because all the denominators have so far just been 1. Well, you'll say that a bit longer because A2 is also 1. What is this going to give us? 3 plus 4 divided by 1, and you get a 7.
Seven.
We got 4 strings of 1. That was already given.
And then you have 2, 3, and 7. Now let's go on, and maybe I will introduce you to the first term, which has a denominator that is not 1, so that you know I'm not cheating. And maybe now you can take my word for it that the next one will be 23. A8 will be 69 plus 49 divided by 2. So you have 118 divided by 2, which is 59. You see, even when the denominator is 2, you still got an integer.
No fractions yet.
No fractions yet. Now, this goes on. This goes on for the whole sequence, that you'll never get a fraction, right? And the next one is 314,1529, and so on. It's doing two things. It's not giving you a fraction, but the number is also growing. It's growing pretty fast. Okay, now you can say, well, that's a bit too much of a coincidence. Okay. One can check it, and there is good reason that it's not giving you a fraction. Okay, now I'll introduce you to another non-trivial thing, and I won't go through the computations, but I'm guessing you can believe me at this point.
Yeah.
I have earned your trust. You have Somos 5. So you just start with 5 ones. Now you can see what's happening. If it's Somos 4, it starts from 4 ones. If it's Somos 5, you start from 5 ones. And this is very important, because if you don't start with all ones, then you do get a fraction. But then it's not really Somos. It's not really the magic of all these sequences. So if you want the magic, stick to the rule that first however number of ones you need to get, you always need to stick to that one. It'll be 2 and a 3, but it won't be the same as Somos 4, of course. You'll get a 5, and it'll go to 11. 37, 83, 274, 1,217, and it goes on.
Integers.
Yep, always integers. So Somos 4, all integers. 5, all integers. So what's really happening? It's curious enough that it's always giving me integers. But then the question is, how far is it going to keep giving me integers? Does it break? Is there some God-given rule? What's happening? So Somos 6, again, all integers, no fractions. Somos 7, all integers, no fractions. Somos 8, something happens or not? That's the thing. Okay, I'll just write it down.
Okay.
Somos 8, it starts with a string of 8 ones. And what is the algorithm? You have an minus 1. An minus 7, an minus 2, an minus 6, an minus 3, an minus 5, an minus 4 squared divided by an minus 8. So you see, the algorithms are also growing. They're growing very nicely, but there is a nice pattern going on there. These are all ones up to this point. So what's the next digit? It is 4. Now you go on. You have a 7, you have a 13, 25, 61, 187, 775, 5, 8, 2, 7, 1, 4, 8, 1, 5. And this is a 16.
Still all integers.
Still all integers. Clearly I know what I'm doing. So what is a 17 digit? Okay, let's do it. So you have the 16th term times the 10th term, 15th times 11th, 14 times 12, 13 squared divided by 9, which is this term, the last one, times 13. The next one is 5827 times 25, so it's the term before the last one times 25. Now you see the pattern. You have the multiplication of this, and the next one is 775 times 61, which is these two. And then there is 187 squared, which is sitting right in the middle. All divided by 7, which is A9, which is the guy here. And that will equal 420514 divided by 7. And it's not divisible by 7. So
it's a fraction.
Exactly. The rule has been broken.
Oh, no. We got so far.
Yeah.
That was the fraction you showed us at the start of the video.
Yeah. And that's the first fraction that appears in these sequences.
Oh. It's So the other ones went all the ones before went all the way to infinity without a fraction.
Without a fraction, but in the Somos 8 sequence, you get a fraction.
Is that the only fraction?
No, that's the interesting part. Now you can continue, and you get. So let me write this down. 420514. We'll give this a special box because it's the first fraction. It deserves its own box. And then you got 28670773 divided by 91. Fraction, not an integer. And this goes on. You get quite a lot of fractions. It's not very clear if you'll find an integer somewhere, but up to the first 30 digits or so, you never get an integer again.
All right, okay. So this is where it breaks.
Yeah.
So what happens with Somos 9 and 10 and 11?
Same thing. You'll think you'll get integers in the beginning, but you'll eventually see fractions. And there is an interesting thing also about which term is a fraction.
Somos 8, the 17th term breaks. Now what happens for Somos 9? It is the 19th term. And for 10, it's the 20th term. So it's almost twice as whatever the number you're getting here.
What happened? What changed that made it break all of a sudden when it was doing so well and always staying as integers?
That's a hard question. There is quite a lot of deep understanding of these the algorithms that I wrote down. Those are very, very important for all sorts of things. So for example, the Somos 5 algorithm, which was this guy, this comes out as some discrete integrable system. That's the buzzword. So there is a good reason why these are just integers. But I don't know why it breaks at a higher order. But when it doesn't break, we have some understanding of what's behind them. So there are these things called cluster algebras, which are associated to them. There is all sorts of very, very nice mathematics that is also very recent. So that's one of the reasons that these are super exciting.
That's exciting, that number there. 420,514 over 7.
The troublemaker.
Yeah, the troublemaker number.
Or the trendsetter.
Oh, yeah, that's true as well. Yeah, it's a more positive spin.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
The trend-setting number for all these sequences.
No, I like troublemaker.
Okay.
Never failing. So there is this constant somewhere out there in the world of numbers with this formula, which will give you every prime number in order as well, not missing one.